little sugar.
Life should turn down low. Let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. When we finally kiss goodnight, how I'll hate going out to start. But if you really hold me tight, all the way home I'll be warm. My heart is slowly dying, and my dear, we're still goodbye. Long as you love me so, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow.
You sit by the fire, you're cozy, cold. He don't care about the cold and the winds that blow. He just says, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow,
let it snow.
Ooh-wee, goes the storm. I surely worry when he's nice and warm. His gal by his side and the lights very low. He just says, let it snow, let it snow.
Weather outside is frightful, but that fire is delightful. Since there's no place to go, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. It doesn't show signs of stopping, and I've brought lots of corn for popping. The lights are way down low, so let it snow, let it snow, let it snow,
let it snow.
When we finally say goodnight, how I'll hate going out in the storm. But if you'll only hold me tight, all the way home I'll be warm. Fire is slowly dying, and my dear, we're still goodbye. Long as you love me so, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow.
Hi, Tricia.
Hey.
How's it going?
Good. Couple minutes till we're live. I mean, we are live.
We are live.
Till we're live with people.
Yes.
Maybe. I don't know. We'll see.
We have six people on.
Okay. Well, hello.
This is good. Six people already.
That's
hello.
Awesome.
Hello, 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 and welcome.
We're going to have fun this morning painting this amazing painting. I'm not going to get into it till we start, but you guys are going to have fun. Have your cup of coffee, though. I don't know where you're from, but here in Canada.
Got Kitchener.
Okay, good.
Madonna White from Kitchener.
Hello. Hello, Madonna. Awesome. Glad you're joining us this morning. You got your coffee. Are you a coffee drinker? Maybe you're not a coffee drinker.
I'm not a coffee drinker.
Yeah, first. Steve's not a coffee drinker or a tea drinker. But I like something hot in the morning for sure.
Do you?
Especially in Canada, yeah.
Well, you see me every morning.
You're going to hear some bad jokes like that this morning. I'm so sorry. I'm going to apologize ahead of time. Yes, I do see you in the morning. I never use the word hot to describe you first thing in the morning, but let's do it. You're looking hot this morning.
There we go. I'm feeling good. My spirits are lifted up.
Your spirits. Well, it is the Christmas season, so hey. Awesome. Okay, so we will get started just in 1 minute. We need a countdown.
We need a countdown?
Yeah, we need some kind of countdown on.
It's 1 minute to go. Let's see. I could do a timer on my phone.
We have Christmas music playing in the background. I don't know if you guys can hear that. This is the one Christmas song that I hear over and over every Christmas that probably is the one that I'm like, oh, not again.
Are you going to sing it for us?
No, you don't want me singing. Really, you don't. I can paint, but singing's a whole other thing.
All right, let's see. Countdown timer. This is just for us.
You probably only have like 30 seconds. I don't know.
What?
It's 10:29.
Let's do a minute. Let's do a minute countdown.
1 minute to start. Right. Oh, okay. I was thinking you're going to put it on the screen.
No, I will. It's backwards, though.
There you go. Yes, it is
backwards. It's backwards. Oh, we have coffee. Oh,
awesome. Hi, Debbie. Hello, Debbie. Thanks for joining us. I'm excited. You're excited. Yeah, your paintings are going to turn out amazing. We're just going to say that ahead of time. Yes, they are going to be great. This is a simple painting. So you guys will do it. I know you will.
It'll be fun.
Yes.
It'll be good.
And we're here to help you. You can text us any questions you have. So we will help you.
Any questions you have.
It is 10:30, Steve.
It is?
Yes, it is.
Well, my clock says I still got 23 seconds. 22.
Well, you started it late.
I might have.
Well, that's okay. Anyways. Okay. Well, we'll do 15 more seconds and we'll officially start. And we're
Allison
down to
Kaiser on. Hello. 10, hello.
9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
It's time now, Lucy Trishy.
All right. Yay.
Oh, I got a duck. I got a duck timer.
Well, welcome. We are so glad you're joining us. And if you're joining us later and watching the replay, we are glad that you're doing that as well. We are going to be showing you how to paint this painting here, Silent Night.
Let's center it. There we go.
There we go.
There. That's better.
So Silent Night, it's not silent and it's not night, but we're going to be painting this. This is a fun painting. It is not overly difficult. So I'm going to say that right off the hop because people always ask me, is this painting hard? Like whatever painting I'm doing. And you know what? It really does depend on the person, but this one's pretty simple. And mm-hmm. I think you guys are going to pull this off and they're going to be awesome. So saying that, I would love to see what you create after. If you want to put a picture in the chat, or they can also probably
put a picture in the chat. They have to put a picture up on our social media, Facebook or Instagram. Okay. That'd be a great spot to share it.
Social.
We'll set a post up. Oh, Lisa's watching. Hi, Lisa.
Hello, Lisa. Did you get your coffee? Are you a coffee drinker? I think you are. So yeah, we will send us pictures. We'd love to see what you do. And we'll send a link how you can send a picture if you want. Okay. But you don't have to. This is a nice thing of doing this in your home. You do not have to show anybody what you're creating. Just those that are in your home, maybe will see. But you may want to. You may want to hang your paintings up and show everybody. So feel free to do that too. So I'm going to quickly just go over a few things just before we get started, because I know I've mentioned this before, what we need. But just to make sure everybody is understanding what you need is you don't have to have an easel. So I do have an easel. But you don't have to have an easel, but these are great. They're just tabletop easels. They just fold up really easy and you can keep them and store them. They don't take up much space at all, but you're going to need a canvas, right, Steve?
Yes. You're going to need canvas. I'm saying hello to Paulette from Cambridge. And who's that? Oh, Westview Baptist Church from London. Hello. Welcome.
Welcome.
Glad to have you with us.
We're glad. Yeah. So canvas sizes, it really depends. This one I'm going to do today is going to be a little bigger, 1620 by 20, because I want you to see it well. Where I thought if I paint it on this one, which is 12 by 16, you'll see better on this one. But you're just going to, whatever size you have, you're just going to size it to your canvas. So you're just going to kind of eye it up. So you could even do this one on wood. I love painting on wood. I don't know if you guys have ever tried painting on wood.
She does it all the time here at home.
It's awesome.
Sometimes the wooden floor too.
Not intentionally. So you want your canvas. You want to have a couple different brushes. Okay. So you don't need a lot of brushes. And especially for this one, the majority of this whole painting, I'm going to do with one brush. It's kind of a mid-sized brush, but you can have bigger ones. You can have small ones for little details. Okay. Also, if you guys have like a Sharpie or a felt tip marker, this is a Sharpie felt tip marker. We're going to do a little outlining. You don't have to have this, but that's an option. You can always go back after and do that as well. You want to have your rag just to wipe your brushes with.
Dab my face when I'm getting hot.
Dab Steve. Yes. you can use paper towel if you're at home. Rags are better. Fabric is better. It just will absorb the paint better. But you can use paper towel. If you guys are painting on the surface, you're concerned about getting painting on, I would recommend having some kind of tablecloth. This is just a plastic tablecloth that you can stick underneath there. And then you're going to need your paint. Now, I got these and a plate. You can use a plate. It will wash off plates on this stuff. You can use a paper plate, but it really absorbs. The paint will really absorb the paper, so it doesn't work as good with paper. These are butcher trays. They're amazing. I just bought a whole lot for my events. I actually bought as many as I could before they sold out in two stores, so I'm waiting for more, but we're going to use these for our live events that we do out in the public. They're amazing. You can mix all kinds of – you got lots of mixing space. And it shows up really nice. It mixed great on this. So some kind of tray, an apron, or old clothes. Right, Steve? Because you, if you do get paint on your clothes, these are acrylic paints. They don't come out of your clothing very easily. Not easily. I know, because my clothes are covered. Right, Steve?
Debbie's asking, is this acrylic or watercolor?
It is acrylic, but we are going to mix a lot of water with it. It's going to give it a really cool look. It's going to be a different technique that we're going to be using today.
Now, so I have a question before you start.
I'm ready to start.
And this is for our audience. We have the music playing in the background, so please let us know in the chat if you can hear us fine or if the music's too loud, and we'll adjust that. I'm going to be behind the scenes, so I'll be watching the chat on a different computer. And so if there's anything you need, any questions you have, make sure enter it into the chat, and I will try to make sure I get you taken care of, okay?
Steve's on it.
All right. Until
he's usually later. Like my paint pourer when we go out and do events, so you're going to be like, what are you going to, the go-to guy anyways today?
Yeah, sure.
Okay, perfect. All right. All right.
Have fun.
So we're going to get started. Yeah, if the music's loud, let us know and we'll turn it down. Or maybe you have some requests. Maybe you want to listen to your own Christmas music at home. So I'm going to start with my bigger brush just because this is a bigger space. You also, I almost forgot. You also need coffee, okay? So instant coffee is great. I just put a little bit of that in my cup here. I didn't mix any water with it yet. I'll show you how to do that when we get to that point. Okay. So have lots of water. I actually have two jars because it's going to get dirty pretty quickly. And sometimes you just want a little cleaner water to pick up. And you can also have a hairdryer when you want to dry your painting a little faster. It's going to speed up the drying process. Okay, so the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to dip my brush and get it really wet, okay? And then I'm going to put water just on this canvas, just along the top, okay? So I'm just going to put lots of water here. Okay, so that's on there. I just wetted the very top part. I didn't do the whole thing, just the top. I'm going to mix up this blue that you see here. So this blue is a little bit of a like a soft aqua kind of color. So to do that, I'm taking my blue. Okay, this is phthalo blue. And I'm going to take a little bit of yellow. Not too much yellow, just a tiny bit of yellow. A tea bag will work. Yeah, if you don't have coffee, you could probably stain it with a tea bag. Sure. It might not be as bold, but it would still work, I'm pretty sure. And I'm going to pick up some white. And I'm going to do a little bit of blue. Now, if you notice when I'm mixing colors, I'm only taking a little bit of paint at a time. Sometimes I see people just scooping up a ton of paint and scooping up another color and mixing it together. And then it takes forever to find the color you want. So I totally recommend just mixing little dab, little dab, little dab, till you kind of get the color you like. Okay, so I like that color. it's going to be diluted with water, so it's not going to be as dark as what I'm seeing it right now on my tray. So now I have all that paint on my brush. I'm going to dip it in my water, okay? Just dip it in like that. And we've got this wet. And don't worry if it does stuff like this. It's a messy painting. So that's why I do recommend having something underneath here, like a tablecloth. If you're a real, what's the word? Like everything's super tidy and organized, you might have a challenge with this painting because that's not what this one is. So you can see how I'm just placing it on and I'm picking up water and I'm letting it drip. Okay. I'm not worried about these drips coming down. Just letting this all drip in here. And I'm even leaving some white spaces in between, okay? I'm not feeling like I have to fill in the entire background. So then I'm just, you notice I haven't picked up more paint. I've just been picking up water. Do this. Just bringing it down here. I'm not going to worry about doing the very bottom. So if you're thinking of like, oh, I'm going to start painting down here, just let the drips drip for now, okay? And I'm just letting them kind of run down. Now, at any time if I want it to get a little bit darker, then I will just pick up more of my paint. But before I put it back onto my canvas, I first am going to dip it in my jar of water again. And I'm just letting it flow down my canvas. How's everybody doing? Hopefully everyone's doing okay with that. Again, you don't necessarily have like total control over this painting because the drips will kind of go as they want. So I'm going to be taking this color down to, I'd say till there's about a third of your canvas left on the bottom. Okay. So that's basically you take your hand and you have it open a little bit. You've got about a third. Now that's just a rough estimate. It doesn't have to be exactly like that. And you can just take, if you watch, I'm just taking my brush and I'm just kind of like guiding that down. Okay. So you can kind of almost like a scrubbing kind of motion, kind of like this. Anytime you add more water, you're going to get more drips. But do you see how some parts of it are faded? Some are a little darker. It's kind of the look I'm going for. I'm going to pick up more paint now, and I'm going to just go along the top because the top part, I might want to do it a little bit more darker. And if it gets too dark, just take your brush into the water and let it kind of drown out like that. I'm not going to go much further down, just a little bit here. So you got this kind of like washed out, kind of cool look happening. And you can bring some of this down further. What I do like is I like that it's not like a straight line across. You notice like this is kind of up and down. I think it looks more natural when you just have like you just kind of full stop with a color and then start with another color. It's not as natural. So we're just going to kind of let this fade out a little. Some of it's going to be longer than go down further. And it's just kind of melt. It's kind of messy. It kind of looks like a sky, kind of creates its own clouds on its own with the water. All right. So hopefully you guys are all, Steve, are you on the chat?
I'm on the chat.
All right. I'm just trying to make sure we got anyone's questions answered there. How are you guys doing with that? Can you just even send a thumbs up or something like that? So then I know you guys are kind of getting this kind of technique because the next thing we're going to do is we are going to do the coffee next. So you're going to want to have your coffee ready. If you don't have coffee and you want to try a tea bag, try a tea bag. What I would recommend if you're doing a tea bag is probably you want to get it, boil it, like have it hot. And then you're going to take the bag and squeeze some of that, like kind of rub that tea onto your canvas. Bet you didn't think you were going to be painting with tea. All right. So this will take a little bit to dry because it's pretty saturated. but that's okay. We're going to let it dry, but we're going to work along the bottom now with our coffee. So what I'm going to do, like I said, I just have this instant coffee. Okay. I love actually painting with coffee. This is my new thing. You can take any painting and add coffee to it and just put it over top of what you've painted once it's dry, and you're going to get a like aged vintage kind of look. It's very cool. So I'm going to take a mid-sized brush. Steve, you coming into paint too?
Tastes like burnt water as far as I'm concerned.
I love coffee. What's your favorite coffee? I'd love to hear. Well, you don't drink coffee, so no. You don't really have one. No. But
I love the smell of it though.
I love the smell of it. And I can't, to be honest, I can't drink a lot of it, but I think that's why I like painting with it so much, because it kind of satisfies that need to smell it,
coffee.
You know? Yes. Anyways, okay, so I mixed some water. What I'm doing is I took my brush and I'm dipping it in my water and I'm mixing it into the coffee granules. Okay. The water doesn't have to be hot to do this. Okay. It's just cold water. But I'm mixing it in there, and you're going to see, I'm going to start on the bottom here. I want it wet, and it's going to start to stain your canvas. So there's a lot of white spots I purposely left here, and you might get some little granules sticking in there. That's okay. You can always wipe them off, but just mix it with water.
You guys can kind of see how I'm doing that. Like that.
And I'm just kind of letting it drip. I'm going right up to where I kind of last left off with the blue. And I'm filling this in. And some spots might be a little darker. And even if you go over some of your drips, that's okay. It's going to alter the color a little bit, but it still will look really cool. We want this kind of to look a little bit kind of worn and aged, kind of rustic, right? This painting is really simple. I love it. Kind of represents, you know, the birth of Jesus, just being very simple in a manger, you know. So this is kind of just a very simple painting. And so you can see I'm just doing the same thing, but this time with coffee instead of with my paint. So just taking the water and letting it drip. I love the smell of that. Don't forget to smell. And don't forget to take a sip of your coffee if you are drinking coffee. Huh?
Don't forget to smell.
Uh-huh. Don't forget to smell your canvas. Smells so divine. So I'm just going along here. And even if some of those drips that you have from your blue come through, that's okay. That just is adding a little more character to your painting. Like I said, this isn't meant to be like a real detailed, painting that is everything has an exact spot. It's supposed to be a little bit more messy, a little bit more free-flowing. So yeah, let that freedom in you out today as you're painting this. Just get free with your brush. Sometimes I think the more uptight we get about wanting our paintings to turn out, the worse they get sometimes. And sometimes when we can just like freely let go, you might find that you create something really amazing. So yeah. And what's like the style inside of you that kind of needs to break out? So I like this, how some of this is lighter. And then if I want it a little bit like darker, like there, I did it darker, just put it on thicker, just have more, less water and more of that coffee in there. And you're going to get like really darker shades of that brown happening there. Now, if you don't have coffee, you could do this with brown paint. So I like the coffee. Besides the smell, I like the color of it. It's kind of like that aged look, right? Which you can get with brown too, but maybe not quite the same look. So But you could totally do that. Is someone trying it with tea? Just curious to see if there's someone that is using tea. And if you are, how is this, how's the tea going for you? Is it going on nice? It should, I would think. So I'm just, you know, dabbing this in again. Just kind of keeping it wet, pouring it in here. But you do want to have enough of this along the bottom part, because that's where our manger and that is going to go. Are you guys ready for Christmas? It's only December 2nd. And I feel like this year I have been more ready for Christmas than I have in past years, except for I'm not done Christmas shopping. But that never happens for me until like the week of Christmas. Have you guys done your Christmas shopping? 1 year, and I'll never do it again. I went out and I started Christmas shopping in August. Do you remember that, Steve?
I do.
Yeah. And so my closet, because that's where I put all my gifts. Hopefully my kids aren't watching. My closet was so full of gifts that I forgot by Christmas time what I had all bought. And then when I went,
it's scary,
to get all the gifts out, which I do Christmas Eve, I was like, wow, how much did I spend? Because over what that was, like, what, 3 months? I had spent ridiculous amount of money. I had forgotten gifts I had bought. I was like,
jackpot for the kids.
I just kept loading up because I was like, you know, making sure, I wanted to make sure I had enough gifts. And it was crazy. And so I was like, budget, I'm never doing that again.
The budget got a little blown that
year. That year it got really blown. Kids loved it. But anyways, that doesn't work for me. I know some people love to do their Christmas shopping really early and it works for them. They're probably a little more organized than I am. Okay, so, and even if you want to leave some canvas peeking through like I'm doing here, you can do that. Or you can cover it all up. So any areas that you want to make a little bit darker, you can also just go over. This, even though we're working a lot with water, it will dry fairly quickly because acrylics do and coffee does dry. So if you don't want it just all brown here, all blue here, like in this one, I added coffee up here too. So a lot of this already, if I just touch it, is dry, okay? If it's really wet, I would say get your hair dryer out, blow dry your painting, and let that dry a little bit more. Or, you know, wave it, whatever, get it dry a little bit more. But I'm going to just like, and this is what I love about the coffee, is it doesn't really alter the present color that you have on there. It just enhances it a little. So I'm going to just put, and I'm not going to put as much, but I'm just going to, I want to just kind of add a little bit more with that water up in here, just because it's going to tie the whole painting together instead of just having blue and brown. I mean, you could do that, but I'm going to take a little bit of this coffee and I'm going to add that in there. And so it doesn't look like solid lines. I'm just kind of like softening the edges with water so they kind of just run. You can take it right up to the top. So I'm just sporadically kind of like with water kind of pushing it out and around. And I'll do some up in here too. How many of you like a white Christmas?
That's the only time I like white.
I know. That's when Christmas. I like the snow. I was hopeful the other day when we got all that snow here. And now it's raining. So we'll see. I was looking at my pictures from last year this time, and we had a lot of snow last year. This year, very different now.
Very cloudy. Last night was an amazing Northern Lights night, apparently.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, we don't get them very often in our area. But there was so much cloud, you couldn't see it. So disappointing.
How many of you guys have ever seen the Northern Lights? I know I haven't. I don't know if they can hear you, Steve.
Amazing.
All right. So I'm just like putting that coffee in. Doesn't it smell like?
It does smell like coffee.
Like a freshly brewed pot.
Coffee grinds.
Yep. So what you can do is like once you decide you have enough in there, you want to stop. So I always tell people when you like your background, leave it because you can keep going and going. Right? Have you done that, Steve? Have you ever done that?
And going,
yes. Yeah. And then you're all like, ah, oh, I don't like it now. And then it's very hard to get it back to what you had. So sometimes less is more too. I'm sure you've all heard that. But I'm going to just put a little bit more in there. And you can always afterwards, after we've got the stable on and everything, you can always come back and say, oh, I want to add a little bit more coffee, because you can do that after. So I'm going to just, these lines, I'm going to blur them a little bit. And so how I'm blurring them again is I'm just taking water on my brush and I'm just letting that kind of soften my edges a little. Just like that.
Lovely.
Now, Steve had mentioned that I have some coffee granules on my canvas. I personally like that
like,
look.
Is that like scratch and sniff for later?
Maybe. Flick. Scratch and flick. You can like kind of just flick them off with your brush if you don't like that look. You just or just put water and work them in.
How long
does I kind of like that look because I'm going for that rustic kind of look.
How long does the coffee smell last on your painting?
Yeah, I will smell that. Does it smell?
Let's see.
Here's the test. Can you smell it?
Actually, I can. I
really?
Can smell it, yes.
That's amazing. Let me smell. I've never tried it. I don't smell it.
You don't?
No. I think you're smelling this.
I might.
I don't know. I did this one weeks ago, so I wouldn't expect it to still smell, but.
You never know.
Maybe.
If I put water on it, it might reactivate it.
Yes, it could. So, and, yes, yeah, you could reactivate the smell. Some spritzing some water on there. You could try it. Okay, time for a drink of coffee now. Like I said, I don't normally drink coffee, but this morning I am. I love it. It just doesn't love me.
Higher than a kite.
Okay. So anywhere, like if you wanted it lighter up here, like this one's darker, but I like that. I'm going to leave it. You could, again, just go over top of it with water, or you can mix a little bit more white with that blue mixture and even put some up there. Actually, maybe I'll just show you that so you guys can see. I do love these trays. Okay, so I'm going to take a little bit of white and make my blue mixture even lighter. You guys can see that. Okay. And I'm going to mix more water. It's not going to show up there. Never mind. I'm going to take white. And I'm going to put white right on top. White paint right on top that's diluted a bit with water. So my brush is pretty wet. And put some up here along there. So you could lighten that if you wanted to. Any area you want to lighten, you could do that. Just take white. I wouldn't even mix it with your blue. And white and water. White paint and some water. And you can put some white in there. So I'm going to let that stop. I'm going to stop for a minute because I want this to dry a bit. And what I would recommend, if you do have a hairdryer, you can dry it. Otherwise, give it a few minutes. Grab your coffee, tea, whatever, before we start the next part of this. I do like adding a little white in here. Nice thing with it having it so wet, you can blend those colors really easily. Is it a really nice faded look? All right. How's everybody doing? Okay. Looks like you guys are doing okay. Awesome. Anybody, if you guys are from a different part, let us know. Or even if you're from around here. We're painting today out of my kitchen in just outside of Stratford, Ontario. So that's where we're located. Beautiful Stratford. It's very nice at Christmas time. Just adding some more white in there. So I'm pretty happy with my background. And like I said, it's going to change a lot when we put our stable and our manger and all that on there. So I'm going to leave it. I might do a little bit more work with it at the end, but for now I'm going to leave it. So I'm just going to put my brush in there. I'm going to give that a minute to dry, fan it a little bit. And see, while we're waiting for that to dry, I'm going to quickly show you some of our new paintings that we are going to be doing in the next month and January as well. So let me just grab. Can you grab those, Steve?
I can.
Can you grab the stack?
Why did
you
I
can
pass
fan
them?
It.
Why did I pass them one at a time?
Okay. So this one is going to be done on a board. It's a cute little sign. We're doing hot cocoa. We're going to be having a hot cocoa bar to go with it in Kitchener. That one. It's really fun. A lot of these come with stencils. So if you're nervous about drawing, don't need to be. So this is our famous snow
here, move over.
Gnome.
Move over.
And
coming in.
Our, coming I forget, in. Snow gnome and winter gnome, I think. And Steve's going to, we're going to be having a double decker kind of night, right? Double header, not decker, header.
Double header.
And Steve's going to be painting one of these. I don't know. I think
you tell us whose turns out better.
And I'm going to be painting one at the same time. So yeah, they're so cute. Those are happening in Kitchener as well. We did some in Stratford already. This one's happening in Stratford in January. Nice cold winter January day at Montana's. This one's happening at the Rabbit Fox in Kitchener. And I did put a little coffee on that. So this is a painting I did a while ago. And then I went over top of it with coffee and it gave it that kind of like aged look. Kind of cool. And this one we're doing in Guelph at the Humane Society. Again, we're going to be using a bit of water with that one. This one I don't have up yet, but this one I'm hoping to do as well. So my dear, these are marshmallow snowflakes. We actually are going to be dabbing with a marshmallow. And if again, if you're like, I can't paint that, comes with a traceable, so you don't have to sketch it out. And I don't know, I might do this one online. I lost my H, but cheers for New Year's. If you like glitter, I don't know. I love glitter. Glitter is great. All right. Thanks, Steve.
No problem.
Thank you. All right. So I think we're good. I'm going to show you the next step, which we're going to do is we're going to start on doing the manger. Okay. So I'm going to take this rounded brush like this. Okay. And I'm going to have it wet. Most of this whole painting, you're going to have lots of water. And I'm going to mix up a chocolate brown. So if you have a dark brown, that's great. But I'm going to take a little bit of black and brown and get a nice, really dark color. Okay. And I'm going to have it wet again, dip my brush back in the water. Here about right in the middle of my canvas, okay, so about, you know, a small handprint up, I'm going to drop some of this dark color in there, okay? So again, I have it wet, and I add a little more brown to it. I want it a little bit. I'm just dropping that in here, and I'm going to let it drip down even to the bottom here. And again, I don't want it to look like it's just like a cone shape. So I'm going to like go out here a little bit, putting water on it, a little bit over here. So the manger is going to go over top of there.
Okay, so don't worry if it's just like right now looks like a line. You are going to place the manger on there. So that's going to kind of change the look of that. And I'm going to just put a little bit more out here. So you can put this color as much as you want in there. It's just like a darker shade, just adding a little more interest to your background. I put a little bit in there.
Okay.
And that's probably all I'm going to do with that. I mean, you could add a little bit of the darker in here if you wanted to. I'm going to probably just leave it. And maybe I'll do a little bit more after when I get my stable on there. Okay, so once you have that on there, I'm just going to give it a quick fan. Again, I wish I had my hair dryer right now. I just blow dry it real quick, but you don't have to. And what we're going to start working on next is we are going to do the manger. So again, the manger is kind of messy. And it's going to be like you're going to be doing like strokes that are kind of like a rocking motion. So you can use, if you have like a smaller brush that's got a little bit of a tip to it. I don't know if you guys can see that very well. I love this brush because it's rounded. I like rounded brushes. So I'm going to have this wet, but it's not going to be as drippy as what we've had going on with our background. Okay. So it can be damp, but I am even going to just like, I don't want it to be like puddles of water coming off the brush like I've had with the rest of it. Okay. So again, I'm going to take, I'm not going to use that mixture I just mixed up because it's too diluted. It's too wet. So I'm going to take black and brown again and make a nice chocolatey color here. So the first thing we're going to do is it's going to kind of be in the shape of like a C, but not like a loose C. I don't know how to, a loose C. So kind of like, and you want to be in the middle, up a bit. It's kind of actually not a C, a smile.
Think of a smile.
You put a smile in there. And again, I don't have my brush wet. It might be a little damp, but it's not soaking wet for this. If you have it really wet, everything is just going to keep dripping, which is fine. We can still work with that. You can still apply paint after it dries over top of it. So this is still a little damp, but that's okay. And then I'm going to do another line. Kind of like that. It's kind of messy. Okay. We're not going to worry about staying within the lines. Okay. So you're going to do all kinds of short little strokes. And do you see, I'm just doing light feathery kind of strokes. So they're just kind of back and forth. I'm going to put some brown in there. Keeping the same kind of shape. And then you can have some that kind of shoot out here. So I'm just doing quick, short little strokes. My touch is light. I don't have a very strong, heavy hand when I'm doing this. It's pretty light. So it's kind of like a messy, have some, they go like this, and then some going out this way. Okay. You guys are getting that. Okay. I'm not doing too much more than that because I don't want it to be all manger and then you don't see Jesus. So you want to have some manger, something like that. We will add white to it after. So you can take like dark brown, and then you can just take some brown even and put some lighter shades in there too. But you're going to get this fun kind of loose manger looking. Hopefully it looks like a manger. Okay. So once you guys have that, we are going to put the legs on it. Everybody doing okay? It's so hard when I can't see you all and see what you're doing. Trusting that you're all getting this okay. And if you're not, feel free to pop any questions you have in the chat.
Yes.
Right, Steve?
Please pop something in the chat. I would like to respond.
Let us know that you're alive and that you're painting. Maybe you're just watching today.
Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to put a line that comes down on a diagonal like that. Okay. So one kind of coming up there. And again, this is with the brown and the chocolate brown. And then it's going to form an X. So this one's going to go diagonal on the other side. And again, this doesn't have to be perfect in any way. They don't even have to be the same size because the style of painting isn't perfect. Remember that. And if you want to add a couple more loose little, you know, lines here, you can do that. We will add a little white to it in a minute. It's Christmas
time. But there you have your manger. So hopefully you got something that looks like that. Maybe you're seeing something totally different. I just encourage people to go with whatever you're seeing. A lot of times you'll get ideas, creative juices start to flow, and you know what? You don't want to miss those opportunities because yours might turn into something spectacular if you do what you know what's coming to mind. So, all right. So next I'm going to wash that color off in my jar of water. Like I said, if your water is getting really dirty, you can have another cup or wash it out and just get some fresh water. So I'm going to just wash that brush off and I'm going to dry it. Take a sip of my coffee. That's not hot anymore. Anybody drink cold coffee? I do. I'm drinking cold coffee all the time because it always goes cold because I get busy. Very rarely does my coffee, do I ever finish a coffee still hot? Okay, so I'm going to pick up white paint on my brush. Okay. And I'm going to, on the one side of the leg here, I'm going to just dab a little bit of white on there just so it will highlight it a bit more. And then I'll do a little bit more white on the other side here too. Just put a little bit of white there. If you get lots of brown on yours because it's still wet, you can take your rag and just wipe off that color. And then I'm going to pick up more white and I'm going to just add a little bit, not much, just a little bit in my manger here. Again, just to add a little bit of another color in there. Just helps make it pop a bit more. So something like that. You can add as little or as much as you want to. All right. So there we have our background. We've got our manger in there. Next, we're going to leave the baby. We're going to leave baby Jesus to after because we want this to dry a little bit more. So we are going to put the stable on. It's pretty simple. You probably all drew houses when you were kids in public school and art class. Same kind of thing. You can use a small brush. Like I said, I'm partial to this brush. But I'm going to do this in the black brown again. And it's just going to go on either side. So maybe leave a finger or two from the sides of your manger. And you're just going to do two lines in a house. So what might be easiest to do is let's do our top first and then we'll bring down the two sides. And again, these don't have to be straight lines. It's actually, if you look at it, it's kind of like, let me bring this up closer so you guys can kind of get a good look at it. It's actually kind of like, you know, rugged looking. Okay. So it doesn't have to be, two perfectly straight lines. So I'm going to take my dry brush. I want my brush dry again. Okay. So it might be a little damp, but I don't want it dripping with water for this. I'm going to take brown and black
and we're going to do the top. So it's going to be kind of in the middle. Okay. So where it peaks is kind of right in the middle. You can even put a little dot there so you know. Okay. So I'm going to just kind of go like this. And if you're nervous to do this in a dark color, you can do it in chalk. You can do it in white. It's easier to kind of like get rid of the white, or chalk would work really well, or you could even do it with pencil. And I would do, if you can, try to do two thin lines, because they probably will get thicker when you're trying to balance them out a bit. So I'm just making this one a little thicker now. And on the side too. And if you don't get it the way you like, well, there's ways we can work with that too. We'll add a, I'll show you some tricks after. I like art tricks. Do you, Steve?
Huh?
Do you like art tricks?
Art tricks?
Yes.
Yes.
Are you paying attention?
No.
I didn't think so. No. Okay. So now I'm going to put my line down here. Using that same color. I'm not going to worry about bringing it right down to the ground there. It's, you can, but it's kind of the style again of the painting, is it was kind of like, we're going to put some drips in there and it's just going to kind of blend in with your background. Okay. So you can have your brush a little bit wet for this. I'm going to just do one down here. And like I said, don't worry if it's not straight. Just gonna go over that a bit. Okay, and then I'm going to thicken these lines. So you can decide how thick you want the stable to be, the lines, okay? So I'm just gonna go over again. I have my brush a little wet. Having your brush a little bit wet actually helps to just kind of smooth the paint out a bit. So I'm gonna have it a little bit wet here. And bring that up there. And the sides come out further than what, the top of the roof rather comes out further than the sides. And it can be kind of messy. You could, have a couple loose, you know, lines there to show like the woods kind of split a little bit. And I'm gonna do this. So you can decide if you want it thicker, just make your lines thicker. You might like the thin look. Do this side. I think I've heard this song, Jingle Bells, already like,
four times?
Way more.
Jingle all the way.
Oh, we need Silent Night on. So you can also like do some like loose kind of lines. I'm going to show you this up close so you get a better idea what I'm doing here. So you could actually have, like, see how this line got away? I like that. Like some loose lines like that. These could be a little bit loose like this. Okay. You want to have enough, we're going to put a like a cross light coming out here. Okay. And then, so I left it like this. I'm going to put some drips here and let the rest of that drip. So it kind of just blends in with the background here. So I'm going to take this brush, have it wet. I'm going to let that drip. Just adding some water to the bottom of there. Rest ye merry gentlemen, let nothing you dismay.
And I got a drip happening here, but I'm not worried about it. I'm going to just let it blend a little bit. And I don't want like perfectly straight lines. So I'm actually creating a little bit of a wobble in the line on purpose. And here too, I don't want it perfectly straight. So I'm just creating a bit of a wobble. And we're going to add a little bit of white to that after too.
And if you want to get rid of a drip, just take your finger and you can just even kind of wipe it or with a paper towel.
Okay.
So you can see it's not perfect.
I'm gonna take some water here and go like this. And you can catch those drips before they get carried away.
So you can decide how far you want it to drip. Take your finger, smudge it a little.
Then you can see down here, I've got these drips kind of just going in here. Something like that. Okay.
So I'm going to add a little bit of a light brown into the wood a little bit, just again to give it some more texture. So I'm going to take, my brush is pretty dry. Not, you can just dry it a little bit on your rag there. I'm going to take some white and some brown and mix up a fairly light brown. It's kind of like a, it's hard to see. I can't really show you because it's dripping my paint, it's tipping my paint. So just white and brown, okay?
More white than brown.
And I'm going to just put some of that kind of etching, broken lines a little bit on the one side of my
stable there.
And I'm going to do it on this side, on this. I'll show you up close.
So it's very faint, but it just adds a little bit more.
In there. Okay. You could add a little bit on the roof if you wanted to. Just blend it in so it's not like just blobs, but it's kind of blended in there. Okay.
I think what would look really good on this painting too is if you had some gold, you could put some gold along here. Gold paint or gold glitter after, I think would look really cool. Just gonna smudge those dots, those drips a bit. All right, so here we have manger, stable. We need Jesus in there. So that's what we're gonna do next. And this isn't very hard to do, don't worry. It's pretty simple. I think it's coming together beautifully. All right. And you can always snap a picture of your painting midstream. I always tell people, like, they often look better on camera, your paintings. So even if you take a picture and you look at it while you're painting it, that what on camera, you might be encouraged at what you're doing. You might be like, oh, that does look good. So I encourage you to do that as you're painting your painting. At some point, take a picture of it. All right. And if it doesn't look better, I'm sorry, but I think it will. I definitely think it will. I feel confident in that. Okay, so I'm going to just take white paint. I don't have any water on it, just white. And to do the baby Jesus, it's going to be like two basic little hills, kind of. So one like this.
These drips are killing us. Not having control of it is hard.
It is hard. It is hard. It's like, and especially if you like having control, it's hard. It's like you have to just let it go. It's kind of like being free. Yeah, it is hard. And some people, it might be easier for than other people, depending on, I think,
personality. A lot of times when you paint, your personality does come out onto the canvas.
Okay, so I don't know if you guys just saw that. I did two. They're just like little hills. We're not going to do the head yet. I'll just show you. And you can kind of catch the drips with your brush. You can kind of stop them or put your finger there and stop them if they're going too far or anything like that.
So can you guys see that? I did a little hill here and then a bigger one here. Okay. His head's going to go right here. And this is just done with white paint.
It's just giving you the shape of the body there. Okay. And I just made sure I left room for his head. This is his body is the length mostly of the manger. And then his head's going to go in the manger still. So I just filled that in all with white paint. We're going to outline it a little bit after, and I'll probably put another coat of white on there. If it's
too blended in and you're having a hard time seeing it with your background, we'll add another layer of white, and then that will make it pop a little bit more.
Okay. So let's just continue with the white, and we're going to just do a circle at the end of this spot here where his head is. So I'm going to do this up close just so that you guys can really see here. It doesn't have to be perfectly circular. And I didn't do like total full circle so that it's resting in the manger. Now you can add hair on there if you want. We're going to change the color of the head. Obviously, it's going to have a little bit more of a skin tone to it. But we're just first putting the first layer of paint on so that we got there, baby Jesus in our manger. Okay. Okay, so then I'm going to take this. I'm just going to wipe any excess paint off. I'm going to let that dry a bit. And then we're going to add the skin color in there, and we're going to add another layer of white on there. But we're going to kind of add those little ornaments here while that's drying. We're going to give that a little bit of drying time there. Okay. So what I'm going to do is, again, I'm going to pick up white paint because I want these to show up pretty dark. So I'm going to first put a layer of white down, and then once the white's dry, we're going to come on top of the white with the yellow and the red. You can do any colors you want. These are just fun ornaments. They're like the shape of a teardrop. So you could do balls, though, if you want to just do round ones. You could do, maybe you've got an ornament that you love that you want to have hanging down. So there's two. You notice they're not exactly side by side. One is a little higher, one's a little lower. Okay, let me bring this closer so you guys can see. So they're just the shape like teardrops. Okay, we will be with the black Sharpie pen, or you could do black paint after. But first, let's do these teardrops. So you're gonna have one longer than the other. Okay, they're off to the side. So let's do them in white first, just to kind of show you. I'm going to do one here. This one's the one that's higher up, so it's not going to have as long of a string with it. And it's kind of, like I said, a teardrop kind of shape. And I'm just doing it in the white with a little bit of a point at the end. Hard to see. Okay. And then you're going to do another one. This one's hanging a little bit lower. Same shape. Can be the same size. It could be a little smaller, a little bigger, your choice. It's just hanging a little bit lower. And I think this should be dry. You guys should be okay to paint on this now. And then you're just going to fill it all in with the white. There we go. Here's our two ornaments. The painting is coming together. So I want that to dry before I put anything else on top of it, any other color. So let's come back to the head now, and let's put in a skin tone so that it looks like he's not just all white. Totally like snowflake color. So to do this, I'm going to take white paint, and my brush is not wet for this. So white paint, red, a little bit of red. You want to make it like a light pink, and you're going to add, you could add either a little bit of brown or a little bit of yellow. I'm going to add a little yellow because we haven't really used yellow yet. And you're going to get a skin tone. Now, if it's too dark, add more white to it. Kind of play around. Just take a little dab at a time till you get it the color you like, okay? And then I'm going to fill in his head with that color. Oh, I want it a little darker. That hardly shows up. Sometimes you don't really know until you get it on your canvas to go whether that's the color you want or not. So I'm going to make mine a little bit darker, because I want it to be different color than, I don't want it to blend in so much with his body. It could be even a little darker than that. I'm gonna add a little brown to that mixture. I guess he probably would have a bit of a brown tone to his skin anyways. Would have been light. So I added a little brown, and I'm gonna take like a darker kind of pink color and just maybe go around the top of his head a bit and make that a little bit darker there too.
So you can see I took it like a darker color with more red in it, and I just kind of laid it in along here to give it a little bit of a more of a shading in there. Okay. We're going to outline a little bit of this too. Okay. So once you have your head, you can rinse off your color there and dry it with your rag. And I'm gonna do another coat of white on his body because I want it to stand out a little bit more. So I'm just gonna put some more white on here so it's a little brighter. One more coat here. And you'll notice on the original, there's a bit of a shadow. Like I said, we're going to do that with our felt tip after. So that's going to have a little bit of a shadow. You can put a little shadow here. So even along, if you want to put a little bit of dark hair here, but even along the backside, I had a little bit of darker, just filled in the manger a bit in here. So you can do that. I'm going to show you how to do that. I'm going to take my brush. This is going to be black, a little bit of brown. And you can just fill in a little bit in here too. You can put a little hair on him. A little bit here. If you want to make your manger a little fuller, should be good and dry, you could do that. I'm just doing a darker color in there. Put a little hair on him. It's just like a dark
brown black kind of color.
Again, it's a pretty light touch.
Looking lovely, Tricia.
Yeah. We're getting there. Not much more. A couple more steps. How's everybody doing? You know, the drips. Are the drips the control? Are they, are you guys liking the drips, I should ask? Or are they like out of your comfort zone maybe?
All right, so we want these to dry a bit more before we add another coat on. So what we're gonna do next is we're gonna come up to the top of our painting. This should be dry, mine's good and dry here. And we are gonna put the cross. So I'm gonna first do this in white. So have my brush dry, taking white. And the first thing I'm gonna do is I'm putting a line right in the middle here, which is hard for you to see.
So it's a line right in the middle. Actually, I'm gonna do this up close so you guys can see it.
Okay, so I'm doing this cross. It's going right across like this. My brush is dry. It's wet, you might pick up paint. So you want this dry. If this isn't dry, like I said, get your hair dryer out. Okay. We are going to go over this in yellow after, but I'm going to also take some white paint and I'm making these like fun little rays coming off the cross here. You can decide how many rays you want to put, something like that. We will add yellow after. You can decide how big you want your rays coming out.
Debbie says you're a good teacher.
Oh, thank you. How's your painting coming, Debbie?
I would love to see it.
So we want that to dry. We're going to put a little yellow on there after.
Let's come back now to these ornaments. Mine's pretty dry.
If you put when you put your first coat of paint on, if you always put it on fairly light, it will dry a lot quicker. If you really put a lot of paint on there, it's going to take a lot longer. And if you want a more textured look, then you want to like layer the paint on like really thick. But if you want a more blended look, you want to put it on thin. So again, this is preference. Depends on what you like. I like both. So, okay, now I'm going to just pick up this yellow. I love this yellow. It's like a warm yellow.
And I'm going to fill in. This is going to show up much better. You can see because I put white on first. I'm going to fill in that shape.
With my yellow, and that should pop out.
And I'm gonna wash my yellow off.
And I'm gonna pick up red. Now, you don't have to do yellow and red. You could do whatever colors. You could do blue, you could do red and green. You could do whatever colors you want. Honestly, I think gold would be amazing in this picture. You put a little glitter in there. Actually, Steve, you should get me some glitter. I can show them at the end.
Glitter.
Steve banned glitter in our house.
Glitter.
But when he's not looking, I don't get it out.
He says, when do we add the beard?
Oh, the beard? What? When do we add the beard? Oh! Yes. You can add the beard on baby Jesus if you want to. I didn't know that he'd had a beard when he was born, but you could totally add a beard. Go for it. Who's that? Cassie? Cassie, yeah. Go for it. All right. I'd love to see it. It'd be unique. It's like your signature painting. Okay, so now I'm going to just take red.
And if this isn't dry, you'll know because your ornament will become pink. Just pick up a little bit more red.
I
fill that in. It's good to do with the smaller brush because it's a little more detailed. So a smaller brush would work good. Here's our ornaments. We're going to add a little highlight to them in a minute. Going to make them a little more interesting, make them pop a little more. Shading makes a huge difference in painting. You can add some shading. It will really make your picture come alive and we'll take it to a new level. All right. I think, what do I want to do next? Okay, we're gonna add a little bit of yellow up to the rays of light we got going on here. Okay, so again, dry your brush, clean your brush. Okay, dry. I'm gonna pick up yellow paint. If you do have a brighter yellow, it does help versus like a butter yellow or something like that. Okay, how do I do this? Okay, so I'm gonna go over some of the cross with yellow just along the side of it. Not necessarily right on top of it, but along the side and along the top of the cross. Okay. And I'm putting my yellow on pretty heavy because I want this to pop. And then I'm just going along the side of these rays of light. I'm just adding a little bit of yellow, a little bit of light. Jesus came to bring us light. He's the light. So we're adding some light here. So you can decide how much you want to put on there. If it gets too much, just go back with your white and tame it down a little bit. If you're like, oh, I don't like it that bright, then just go over top of it with the white and you can make it a little more subtle. So you can kind of play with that until you kind of get it the way you like it. It's just supposed to show like there's just light beaming off around here. And again, I have a fairly gentle touch when I'm doing this. Okay. Couple more steps and you guys got yourselves a painting. All right. So almost. So we're going to, if you don't have a black felt tip marker, you can either do this later and get a black felt tip marker, or you can do this with, like black with paint, black paint. If you're going to use black paint, use a very fine brush. Have your brush a little bit wet, not dripping wet. And you want to roll it in the black paint. And that way you'll get more of a finer line. To do fine lines, again, you do want to have a light touch. Okay. If you go really hard, you're going to get thicker lines. So, but easiest way, honestly, is using one of these. So it's fine. Fine tip. Okay. Not, you could use a thicker Sharpie too, but I like the fine tip. I think it looks really nice. So the first thing we're going to do, let's come along baby Jesus. Let's define him a little bit more. So all I did is, and I'm doing this pretty light, is I went around the top of his body here. You don't have to do the whole body, but you could. And that just kind of defines it. Now, if you don't like that line, if it's too much like, oh, I don't like that look, one trick you could do to kind of make it look like it's not so much like a marker you just used, but it's blended in, take a small brush, take some water, and you can just smudge it. Because most of these will smear, especially when you first put them on like this. And that actually drags that color down a bit. And I actually like that look better than just the marker look, because it looks, it doesn't look like a marker so much. So I'm just smudging it into my, I'll show you this up close so you guys get a better look.
So it's just kind of smeared and it looks a little more natural. Okay. If it's too dark for you, you could even smear it more or put a little white on it and you'll be good.
Okay. So that's that side. We are going to add, we're going to do some shading with the bulbs in a minute, but first let's add the, let me show you on this. Let's add the two little tops of the ornaments. So if you can see, it's just like an upside down frown and then another little one, an upside down frown and then a little, another one on both sides. Okay. Then we're going to add the lines that go right up to the stable. Now, if your line gets a little wobbly, don't worry about it. It doesn't have to be perfectly straight. And then once this is dry, you want to make sure this is dry. If you put your felt tip marker on wet paint, it kind of kills it pretty fast. So once it's dry, you can run on either side, one on each of the left side of your ornaments, a black line right down. And again, you can take your water and you can smear it a little bit. Okay. So I'll show you that. So let's start, because this is still pretty wet. Let's start with the tops. Okay. So I'm putting a little top there. And then one here. Okay. Then a little one. And it's all in the center there. And another little one there. Okay. That's all you have to do for the tops of them. Steve, I think you should play Silent Night.
Silent Night?
Yeah.
To go along with this?
Yeah, because we're almost done. I want to play that song one time. Okay. Right, then see. I'm going to line this up. And you do have a lot more control with a pen than what you do with a, this is harder to do, what you have with paint. Okay, so we're gonna do two lines, one there, and again, if you don't like the look with the Sharpie, go over it with paint. So if I want that to show up more, I could even just have my brush a little bit wet and just, there's just water on this, go over top. And you can see that just makes it stand out more. I'm just going to go over this a little bit more.
Just added some water and that just made it pop a bit more. Okay.
Okay, so I'm not going to do the side yet because this is still a little bit wet, but I am going to add a tiny little bit of a highlight into the ornament. And I'm going to use a small brush. I'm going to pick up white paint. And it's just going to be this little
mark. I'll show you on this side. Oops, I got yellow on that one, but they're white there. Just something like that, okay? Fairly light, and that will just give a little bit of a shadow. Now, if you really love to shade, you could go all out. You could do a darker, you could add a little black to your red, and you could shade the one side. You could add a little red to your yellow and shade that side, and you could go all out with your shading, depending on what you like.
So, what I want to do is just outline the side. We're so close to being done. It's looking awesome, I'm sure. I wish I could see them all right now. Okay, so I'm gonna just go along this side. Again, if your paint is wet, you're gonna want it to dry because it will kill it pretty quick. It will kill the marker, that is. Okay, so one side here. See how that just makes it pop a little more? And again, if you wanted, you could take a wet brush and just go over that line and it will blend even more into your ornaments there, okay? I'll just show you that. This is just wet and I'm just going a little bit. It also darkens it a bit when you put a little bit of water on it. You could do a little shading in here with that too. If you want, if you didn't want the cloth that he's wrapped in, if you didn't want it quite so white, you could just pull some of that black down. Another thing you could do if you wanted it to look like a little more not so clean, you could add a little bit, I didn't in the original, but you could, if you wanted, show that they're not in a like a clean environment, they're in this stable, you could add a little bit of the coffee on there. And then the last thing we did, I did is, and you don't have to do this again, but right in the middle, whoops, there goes my coffee. Good thing it wasn't full. What you could do right in the middle is add a little tiny cross there with the black felt tip marker if you want to. Again, you want to make sure it's dry. So I'm just going to put that in there. And there's your painting. Make sure you sign it. You can sign it. I signed mine in the corner. You can sign it wherever. You could like add so much more to this. This is just the simplified version of this. But if you wanted, I mean, you could add stars, just little like yellow or white dots in the sky here if you wanted to. You don't have to add much. You could just sporadically kind of put them in there. Anywhere you wanted to add a little more highlight, now that it's pretty dry, you could do that. I'm just adding a little more white on here. I mean, you know what? Once you really start getting into it, you could, there's so much you could do, so much more you could add. I just make this a little lighter in here. Your little glares.
But there you have it, Silent Night. So I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Again, if you have any questions, feel free to send them. I'll check the chat later. And you could add more coffee in there if you wanted. If you want more in the sky, you can do that. My coffee ended up on the floor, but there's still some more coffee. There we are. You could add a little bit more of that even. Like, you can always come back with it. That's what I like about painting with coffee. You can always come back. Just watch how much water you add, because you don't want it to get too crazy now that you've got all your picture on there. But you could add a little bit more coffee in anywhere that you want to, or tea. I don't know if the person that was going to use tea, if they actually did, but I don't know how the tea works, but something like that.
That's lovely, Tricia.
Yeah, there we have our Silent Night. I also will be doing some giveaways in the next probably week. I have... Can you show that gnome painting again? I have lots of gnome paintings because I've been painting them so much. So our snow gnome, I have a bunch of them. I'm going to be giving away. If you're in the KW Stratford Guelph, Cambridge area, you can enter to win, and we'll be giving a couple of these paintings away. They're 16 by 20. So yeah, if that's something you would like to do, stay tuned for more of that. We'll be on social art socialart.ca. That's our website. So it's socialart.ca where you can find out more. You can find out our events that we do there as well. And starting in January, Steve, we're going to be doing door prizes at our live event. So if you come out to a live public event, we're going to be having some door prizes to give out.
Good stuff.
Amazing.
So. Yes, they can also follow this on Facebook and Instagram.
Yes.
Social Art on Facebook and Social Art KW on Instagram. And of course, make sure you like and subscribe on the Social Art Tutorials page here on YouTube, because that helps us get the word out about what we're doing as well. So,
yeah. So lots of paintings. We got over 350 paintings. We're always coming up with new ones. So if there's a video of a painting you would like to see happen, let us know, because we can probably make that happen.
Right? Yeah.
All right. So guys, listen, have a super Christmas. Merry Christmas. Hang up your painting. Send me a picture. God bless you. And thank you so much for joining us today.
Bye. Bye. Oh, there we go.
It's the frozen face.
Okay. I'm going to go. Bye.